Hello everybody and welcome back to my part four, the final lesson in my songwriting series. So I hope you guys have had a good time so far writing some songs, and we're just going to get right in back into it today. We're going to hopefully finish up the song that we've been working on, the online school song, and I'm going to try recording part of it into my DAW today, and I'll explain to you a little bit about that and how that works. And let's get into the slideshow here. Songwriting, part four. Here we go. Oops. Okay, so a little bit of a recap from last time. So last time we looked at the pre-chorus and the bridge. So just to recap, a pre-chorus, you know, it's pretty self-explanatory. Pre-chorus comes before the chorus, and it kind of sets up the chorus to be, you know, gives it some teasing language and sets it up so that you're kind of anticipating the chorus, right? And the bridge does kind of the same thing, but in a different way. Usually after the second chorus, you have a bridge kind of bridging between the second chorus and the third chorus, and it puts you in a kind of a different perspective. So you're looking at it, the final chorus, through a new lens, you know, and it brings you into that kind of a new perspective. Anyways, tension and release. We talked about this last time. So creating a lift into a chorus, and you know, all music, it's just tension and release with just like all art, you know, and just in terms of, you know, lyrics. There's some lyrics that are kind of make you feel tense and some lyrics that make you feel free and, you know, happy. And then the music kind of matches that sometimes. You have chords that sound really tense. Oops, my piano is muted. Really tense chords. And then you have really like nice chords, you know? So there's tension and release in everything. And that's all we're doing. We're setting up for the tension just for it to be released into. Ah, that was a bad example. To be released, like, you just like the chords kind of move into the next chord. And I taught you a little bit about how to look at that last time too. We'll get into that in a second. So ascending melody is a really good way to build up that lift into the chorus. You know, starting really low. And then boom, into the chorus. And also, you know, creating a little bit of space. You know, like that little breath that you can take right before the chorus hits can be so powerful. It can be even more powerful than, you know, a pump up, like ascending melody. Sometimes just that little bit of space can be nice. And lyrics wise, teasing the chorus idea. So whatever your idea is in the chorus, what you're gonna be singing about, the main message, you know, in your pre-chorus and your bridge, you're really, especially in those parts, you're really teasing the message that you're going to say in the chorus. But you're never going to say that full thing that you're saying in the chorus. You're never going to say that in the previous sections, because you're saving that main message for the chorus. Like online school, in our example that we're writing together, online school, we decided to not say that phrase until the chorus. It's kind of, you have to kind of figure out through the showing language what I'm about to sing about, and when the chorus comes, it should be obvious that you're singing about online school, you know, or whatever your chorus is about, right? And we also talked about how to create chord progressions using an instrument. Right, so choosing a group of seven notes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then, you know, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. And then in those seven notes, you can make, there's seven different chords you can do. Really six chords that are very useful in that key. All right, so you just have to find out, again, using that circle of fifths that I showed you guys last time, you can easily find out what those six chords are that are touching that one main key note, and just kind of build your chord progression around like that, and just experiment with it, you know, like use those random chords and experiment making your own chord progressions. Yeah, circle of fifths, definitely a really great tool for songwriters. Use chord progressions from songs you like. This is another great piece of advice I've been given as well. I've learned so many cover songs, you know, through my learning of music. I've always been like learning all of my favorite songs, and you know, that's how I became good at guitar and piano, just by learning songs that I like. And if you do that enough, you start to pick up, especially if you do it in the mindset of like the circle of fifths, thinking of this chord as the one chord, you know, like 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, the first one is the one chord. So if you know the numbers of these chords, you can really start to pick out the patterns and the common chord progressions that are in a lot of the songs that you like, probably. Like, especially if you like pop songs, if you learn, you know, the top 20 pop tunes, I think a lot of them will use the exact same chord progression, you know, maybe in different keys, maybe a little bit different tempo, or different, the chords are different lengths, but they're often using those same four chords over and over again. So yeah, definitely, you know, help you make better songs too. So today's class, we're going to look a little bit more about song structure. We're almost done talking about that. Just talking about intros in songs, and also post-chorus hooks, right? And I'm going to talk to you guys about some useful songwriting tools that we can use in our songwriting. There's all kinds of tools out there for you guys these days. You know, it's so much easier to be a songwriter in 2021 and beyond than it was like 10 or 20 years ago. Like, people, you know, they used to just have a pen and paper and a guitar, and that's all you have. But today, man, anybody can set up their home studio and, you know, record a really professional song. And there's just so many tools out there on the internet and the apps and everything to get you started writing songs. So yeah, the hardest part, honestly, is finishing the song. I always struggle with this, because it's easy to start a song, you know? You just... Ziri Panato, I'm gonna write a song and I don't know what it's gonna be about. You know, you just get on a roll and you start writing, but then you kind of, meh, it doesn't sound that great. You throw it out, crumple it out. But really, you should try not to crumple your songs out and throw them away. Try to finish them. And it's hard to know when a song is finished. It's a good question. How do you know when a song is finished? But it's a personal question. Do you think it's finished? And usually the answer is, it's finished if it's been professionally recorded. You know, you can always keep on editing your songs as you go, as you progress as an artist. But yeah, just try to finish your songs to the best that they can be. You know, that's the challenge, I think, which requires a lot more editing than people think. But you know, they don't have to be perfect. Your songs don't have to be perfect. Just try to make it a complete song. And Yeah. Oh, and the end of today's class, we're gonna try recording some of the online school song. Okay. So let's get into it here. Song structure. Post-chorus. All right. So in post-choruses, these are less common than pre-choruses or other things. They're not always necessary, but sometimes they can, you know, create a really nice hook after a chorus that just keeps you in the same groove as the chorus. So, like I said, small section that follows the chorus, usually it doesn't add too much extra information. So often the post-chorus will just be like, oh, 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 you know, just, you know, the Ed Sheeran Shape of You. His post-chorus is just like, ooh-ah, 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 ooh-ah. It's just a hooky and catchy thing that you can do at the beginning of the song and bring it in at the end of your chorus. It's becoming more and more popular these days. sometimes there's lyrics, and sometimes you're just singing vowels, or sometimes it's just instrumental. Like I'm trying to think of Billie Eilish's Bad Guy has a really good instrumental post-chorus hook. I'm a bad guy, duh. I don't remember exactly what it is, but you could probably think of it. It's a, you know, instrumental post-chorus. And these are often hooky and easy to sing along to or hum along to. Alright, so here's some examples of post-choruses. I Knew You Were Trouble by Taylor Swift. So this one, as you can see, oh, oh, trouble, 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 oh, oh, trouble, trouble, trouble. It doesn't add too much extra language to the song, right? It's just kind of, you know, keeps the chorus going, and it's very catchy. So I'll play this for you really quick. If I can remember. When I walked in, it's a shame on me now. I flew me to places I've never been until you put me down. Oh, I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now. I flew me to places I've never been, and now I'm lying on the cold hard ground. Trouble, trouble, trouble. Oh, oh, trouble, trouble, trouble. And then back into the verse. No apologies. All right. Here we go. The second verse here. From Sia, The Chandelier. All right. So this one has a little bit more lyrics in it. So this one is one of the rare cases where the post-chorus actually has a little bit more information. I'm sorry, I'm kind of blocking it here. I'm just going to move over here. All right, so I'm just going to sing this one for you too, if I can remember the chords. Actually, I'm going to put my guitar down for a second. We'll try this with the piano. So it's like... I'm gonna swing from the chandelier, from the chandelier. I'm gonna live like tomorrow doesn't exist, like it doesn't exist. I'm gonna fly like a bird from the night, feel my tears as they dry. But I'm holding holding on for dear life. Won't look down, won't open my eyes. Keep my glass full until morning light. Cause I'm just holding on for tonight, on for tonight. Alright, so again, it doesn't really add too much information. I'm holding on for dear life. Won't look down, won't open my eyes. I'll keep my glass full until morning light because I'm holding on for tonight. It's just kind of a catchy and dancey melody with some interesting lyrics in there. So these are some examples of post-choruses. We might try to do a post-chorus in our song, actually. So yeah, intros and outros. These set the vibe of the song. So right away, when you start the song, you know, you hear that thing, you know exactly what song it is. Like, what is this song? Very Superstitious by Stevie Wonder. Sorry about that clicking. So right away you hear that, especially if you have an interesting instrument too, it can really pull the listener in and be like, ooh, that, like, I like that. Or if they've heard the song before, right away when they hear the intro, they're gonna recognize that, you know? Or what about this? Like, can anybody name this song? I think it's a very catchy intro, and right away, as soon as you hear that first lick, people recognize what it is, you know? So intros are very important. It should contain a memorable hook so that people instantly know what the song is, you know, something, I mean, it doesn't have to be super unique. It can just be chords. You know, it can just be like, just those chords, you know? It doesn't have to be something like that's super different, but having that intro is important to recognizing the song. Usually intros are instrumental, although sometimes they can have vocals, like, you know, the ooh-wah, 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 ooh-wah. It's kind of his vocals part of that intro. Or what else has, yeah, I don't know, some songs start with the choruses, so, you know, there's a lot of rules I'm kind of putting out there, but, you know, a lot of the best songs break the rules, so sometimes you just have to experiment and, you know, see what works. So yeah, some intro examples we have, like, you can recognize this one. One of my favorite intros. And now this also turns into a post-hook chorus, post-chorus hook too. And often intros do turn into post-chorus hooks. So I'm making my way downtown, walking fast, the pace is fast, and I'm homebound. And that little hook just keeps coming back, and it really, you know, it's a really ear, it's an earworm, they call it. Nothing Holding Me Back by Shawn Mendes. That's kind of a guitar hook thing. It's like, and then I think it goes, oh yeah, no, Nothing Holding Me Back. Sorry, that was Treat You Better. Nothing Holding Back. You probably recognize, if you don't recognize these chords, you recognize this part. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna show you this. I'm gonna show you this a little bit later, but I have a little loop pedal down here that I use sometimes for this purpose. So it, so you can make, you can build those intros up like this. You guys recognize that? That's you know, that always oops, I don't know why I left those in there. Anyways, we're gonna talk about some songwriting tools now that we can use to improve our songwriting. There's so many things out there. I'm not even gonna scratch the surface of what's out there for you guys, but we're going to, you know, the most important one, a paper and pen, and instruments. Instruments help too. But again, you don't need instruments. I think you should try to have a big pad of paper, maybe even use multiple pads of paper, and one of them have just rough ideas and just word map and rhymes and everything, and the other one have your, you know, your rough copy of the song and just really write only the lyrics on that one. That's how I like to do it. I actually don't use notepads too much. I usually use like online tools, like I'll show you those later. So another one, audio recorder. This is something that's just game-changing for songwriting, and also for even if you're just learning doing covers. If you can get your phone out and record just from your voice memos, just record yourself playing and then, you know, keep on building on it. So often what I do is I'll come up with an idea, you know, like I'll do a little cut, like I'll take my audio recorder out and I'll come up with a little idea. So like, and then I'll just, you know, I'll riff on it for a couple minutes on that little chord progression, and then I'll listen through it. I'll listen to it again. Sometimes it's a little bit cringy. But sometimes I'll hear a little melody that I really like, and I'll try to come up with a lyric to that melody. You know, so like, what did I have? Na 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 na. So didn't you say that you wanted me? And I don't know. And then every time you try again to do the same thing, or just you improve upon it a little bit, it's like a sculpture. You know, you're sculpting it. And the voice memos app helps so much with that. Also, you can do it on the go. You can listen to your songs that you've recorded, that you're working on, and work on it on the go. You know, listen to it, and then, oh, you can write lyrics as you're listening to it, just on the subway or on the walk to school or whatever. And you can also just record little vocal tracks, you know, oh, I just thought of, like, wouldn't you want to be there? You know, you can just record that lyric line that you came up with and later put it all together. So if you're not using a voice memo app, you must not be a songwriter, I think. I don't know. I think all songwriters use some sort of a voice recording app because it's too convenient. And you need to record those audio ideas. You can't just write those down. Rhymezone.com. You know, we use this during our songwriting sessions a lot. So you guys already know it's the best for coming up with rhymes and near rhymes. Always use the near rhyme or advanced version of it, because it's going to come up with all kinds of different rhymes. And phrase rhymes, too, are really good. There's also a phone app for that as well, Rhyme Zone. Okay, here's one that's a little bit different. A looper pedal. So this only really applies if you can play an instrument. So don't worry about it if you can't right now. And also, I'm gonna show you guys some cool tools if you can't play an instrument later too. But so I'm just gonna show you guys really quick my looper pedal down here. If I can pull it up, there it is. If you guys can see, it's kind of small there. Let me make it bigger. There we go. Okay, so I have some foot switches down here that's connected to my guitar, and I often use this when I'm songwriting because it's really handy. Even if you're not that great at playing, you can create like a 4-bar loop, which is basically you just play your chord progression. So say your chord progression is just simple C, G, A minor, and F, or I should do a simpler one, G, D, and E minor, and C, and you're just playing that over and over again. So I just push that button with my foot, and then it keeps playing. It frees my hands up, frees my mind up to come up with lyrics and melodies on top of this. Ooh, I don't wanna be the dude, I don't wanna do the. You can just loop these things over and over again. And it also, this also helps me a lot to think of rhythms to go with my songs as well. So you can put a little rhythm on here. And when you create a loop like this, it can be really inspirational to coming up with some good lyrics. You know, you just let this, you just put your guitar down and, let this loop over and over again. And just come up with something on top of it. Just, you can sing all kinds of stuff. You don't want it by now. I'm gonna make a song about this now. I don't know what I'm gonna say next, but I'm gonna do it. Da, 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 da. I don't know. I'm not the best with coming up with lyrics on the spot. Usually I come up with melodies first, and then I try to, fit lyrics into them later. But a lot of people are the other way around, and it really just depends on the person. So yeah, looper pedals are something that I love to use. Not essential, but I just wanted to show you guys. Another good tool to use, honestly a songwriter's best friend, is a DAW. And also called a digital audio workstation. And these are programs such as GarageBand. You might have heard of GarageBand. Or Logic, or Pro Tools, or Reaper, or Fruity Loops, or what else is there? There's all kinds of them out there. Ableton is another good one, and these are things that you can record your songs into. You can record the guitar and record the vocals and drums or anything, piano. You can record them all separately, and you build your song in this program. It's what producers use, and it's what all the top music people are using, these things called DAWs. So you might as well get used to try getting used to using it. I think GarageBand is the easiest one in my opinion, and maybe that's just because I'm an Apple person, but I feel like it's the most user-friendly, it's the easiest to get started with for beginners. And it's also free for Apple users. It comes with your phone, with your iPad, with your Mac, whatever. You can always use it for free on there, and it's super useful. Personally, I use Logic, which is almost the same as GarageBand, but it's kind of the advanced version. So I'm gonna be showing you guys a little bit today about that, about logic. Actually, I'll show you really quick right now what a DAW looks like, and then we're gonna get into our thing. So here's a DAW. Basically, you can create different instruments. There's drummer, audio, guitar, or software instrument. And software instrument is something you can connect to your MIDI keyboard. MIDI keyboard is just anything that, you know, any kind of keyboard, like a piano keyboard, that can plug in to your computer. Yeah, so you can make your keyboard sound like anything. Right now it's an electric piano. I can make it sound like a grand piano. I can make it sound like a mallet. And you can also make it sound like, you know, drums. Like, oh, although it doesn't seem to be working. There we go. Okay. Scared me for a second. Yeah, I like to play the drums on my piano like this. And these are things you'll kind of learn to do, you know, as you go along. Anyways, let's move on to, I think there's a couple more tools here. Google Docs is such a good one, especially if you want to work with other songwriters. You can write together over Google Docs. I'm sure most of you know about Google Docs already, and it's great for collaborating. But my favorite thing for organizing my notes is OneNote. And this is something, oops. Let me see. I'm gonna show you guys my OneNote. Hopefully you guys don't see anything too private in here, but you can see all of my different songs here and my songwriting category. And then I also have other notebooks, you know, I have just different stuff, all my original songs in here. I have music. You know, there's just so many ways that you can organize your notes in OneNote, and I find it great for organizing my songwriting notes and my final copies of my songs and all that kind of stuff. So definitely recommend OneNote for you guys. Okay, the last thing, Splice. Now this is something for you people out there who don't play any instruments. Splice is something that has all kinds of loops. So I showed you guys my loop earlier. This is a loop that I've created. Now Splice has all kinds of crazy loops. And by the way, GarageBand and any DAW also has loops like this. So Splice is a paid service for people who wanna have extra fancy and cool loops. But I'm going to show you some loops and stuff in Logic in a second. Oh, and that's it. So we're going to get back into our song now and do some final edits, and then we're going to start recording in Logic. Let me just show you really quick before we start some of the loops on here. So you can go to the loops over here, and let me move out of the way for you guys. You can just click on any of these things. These are beats. Find a beat that you like. You know, there's all kinds of stuff. I'm just gonna pick one. Ooh, that's kind of cool. So I'm just gonna throw that in there. Just throw that random beat in there, and then you can loop it. And then you can pick another, you know, instrument. Maybe you wanna throw some piano on there. So just let that beat loop, throw some piano on there, and you're really creating a song just from this. And then you can, yeah, like that. Okay, so this is a great way to create these loops that inspire you to write lyrics, and then you can just let this go, let this loop, and see if you can come up with some kind of a lyrical idea. Ooh, da, da, yeah.
instrument, and I can make a song without an instrument. With some loop, 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 loops.
Okay, so, so many things you can do out there. Even if you don't play an instrument, you can totally write a song. All right, let's check out where we ended up with our song last week. I'm gonna play it once for you guys, and I'm gonna try to make a loop for our song. And let's see. I think we almost finished it here. Signed into my Zoom class. Internet's so bad, friends all in boxes in the frozen. There's a cat on my keyboard. Somebody's knocking on my front door. Spilled water on my laptop. Now it's smoking. That's pretty good. I'm gonna look through some of these lyrics here and see if I can make some quick edits before I sing it for you guys. I think I like, so spilled water on my laptop, now it's smoking. How am I supposed to learn like this? I think that's, how am I supposed to learn like this? And I can't seem to find the focus. Stuck at home, I'm feeling hopeless. Tired of online school. It's pretty catchy. Technology gonna drive me crazy. Now this is a little bit wordy. I think I want to take gone out of there. I think I just want to do trick. Technology drives me crazy. See if we can get that to work. Technology drives me crazy. Stuck at home on. I don't know if I want to say stuck at home twice because I said stuck at home already. So maybe I want to change that to something. Maybe like lockdown life. Lockdown life, I'm picking daisies. I'm feeling lazy, maybe just feeling lazy. I think lazy. I think it works in this context. Now that's a cool chorus. I'm just gonna make sure I get all the choruses there. Whoops. Right. Copy and paste. All right, after this first chorus, I'm feeling lazy, tired of online school. Then I think we're gonna try to put a little post chorus. So, online school. Dun, 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 online school. You know, something like that. Try that. Oh, I finally rebooted, but my microphone was muted. My friends are all in breakout rooms and I can't get in. The whiteboard is open, but my keyboard is broken. I miss when we could write our answers with a pen. This last one is still a little bit wordy for me, but I can't think of anything else right now. And we got the next chorus and then the bridge. Online school. And I was gonna switch up the chord progression a little bit for the bridge. It's not as bad as it could be. I have to figure out what melody to do for this bridge. It's not as bad as it could be. Let me say it while playing it. Say it while playing it. Sometimes this can help when you're trying to figure out a melody. Just play the chord progression and try to say the lyrics on top of it. And sometimes melody will come naturally. It's not as bad as it could be. I'm grateful for technology. I'm actually gonna say I'm grateful we have technology because I think it kind of lines up better. not as bad as it could be. I'm grateful we have technology. I'm counting all the days till I can see some face. I think that's too much. I just want to see some faces outside the screen. Just simplify. Simplify, simplify, simplify. That's my advice to you guys. Try not to be too wordy unless you're going for like a song that's, you know, like hip hop or something that has a lot of words in it. But a lot of pop songs these days, you know, they're so simple, and there's an art to being that simple. It's not easy to make a song simple. And, you know, people think it's easy to write a top 40 song because they're all just like, seems like songs that anybody could write. They're so simple. But, you know, there's an art to making them that simple. You really have to simplify your lyrics as much as you can. Okay, so it's not as bad as it could be. I'm grateful we have technology. Technology. I just wanna see some faces outside the screen. Then I think I'm gonna go back to my original chord progression. And then go to the chorus again. Okay, I think I'm good. Let's try to sing this song through and then we can start recording it. So make a little loop here. Signed into my Zoom class. My internet is so bad. My friends are all in boxes and they're frozen. My cat's on my keyboard. Somebody's knocking on my front door. Spilled water on my laptop, now it's smoking. How am I supposed to learn like this? Can't seem to find the focus. Stuck at home, I'm feeling hopeless. Tired of online school. Technology drives me crazy. Lockdown life, I'm feeling lazy. Tired of online school. Online school. Post chorus. Sick of online school. Breakout rooms and I can't get in. The whiteboard is open, but my keyboard is broken. I miss when we could write our answers with a pen. How am I supposed to learn like this? Well, I can't seem to find the focus. Stuck at home, I'm feeling hopeless. Tired of online school. Technology drives me crazy. Lockdown life, I'm feeling lazy. Tired of online school. Well, it's not as bad as it could be. I'm still grateful we have technology. I just wanna see some faces outside the screen. Outside the screen. To find the focus, stuck at home, I'm feeling hopeless. Tired of online school. Technology drives me crazy. Lockdown life, I'm feeling lazy. Tired of online school. Online school. So sick of online school. Not bad. Not bad. It's turning out pretty cool. I'm liking how it's turning out. So I added the "so sick of online school." I think it just kind of flows well with it. And what else did I add? There was another thing. See, this is the point in the songwriting that I like to record myself on the voice memo, listen to it again, make a note of all the little changes that I want to make, then make the changes, and then play it again and repeat a few times, a bunch of times, until you are happy with it, the lyrics and the melodies. And then when you're happy with it, you go into the DAW and, you know, record a good demo of it. Okay, so trying to remember, there's one other part that I think I wanted to change. Where was it? Maybe in the bridge. It's not as bad as it could be. I'm grateful we have technology. I just want to see some faces. Maybe it was the second verse. Maybe I made the change already. I think it looks pretty good, guys. I'm pretty happy with it. So let's go into our DAW now, and I'm gonna copy all this. Copy all this here. Whoops. Can I copy? There we go. Copy. And I'm gonna paste it into my DAW right here. We're not gonna write. Might not be as cool as this loop here, but it is fully original. So I'm gonna open up the little notepad here. That's where I can type in the lyrics. And we're gonna get started. So what I like to do in the DAW, and you know, again, it can be, anybody can do this differently, but I'm a piano player. I like to use the keyboard, and I'm gonna make it really simple for you guys. First of all, we need to find the tempo of the song if you wanna record it in here. And for that, I recommend something called an app called Tap That Tempo. And basically, just you have the song in your head. Dun, 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 dun. I'm just gonna tap. Dun, 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 dun. I'm just gonna tell me what tempo it is. It's about a 90 BPM. BPM means beats per minute. So right up here, I'm gonna change to 90 BPM. And I'm gonna make it so you guys can hear my desktop. Okay. So, oops. So I'm gonna record the chord progression. The cool thing about these things is you can record just the chord progression one time, just like my looper, and you can loop it on this program as well. So I'm just gonna do it on piano now. Hey. Oh, hang on. I have to create a new thing here. These, okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so that's it. I'm gonna loop that, and that's most of the song right there, is this chord progression, right? Goes over and over again. Might want to put some drums in there. Let's just do a quick 2, 3, 4. Now, you don't even have to do that much. I could have just done one bar. Let me try one more time. That's probably enough. I can just loop that over and over again. Maybe some maybe some hi-hat cymbals. So, you know, these are all extra things. You don't want to get too carried away with the production. You want to focus more time on making quality lyrics and melodies. And this is all final production stuff that, you know, you don't even have to do. You can take it to a producer if you want. But it's always nice to kind of have these ideas of how you want the song to sound. And that's where these DAWs can be really great. So, two, three, four. I'm gonna try that one more time. Three, four. All right, and we loop it. Actually, I'm gonna do a, sorry, I'm getting too picky. Two, three, four. Okay, loop that. That sounds cool. Alright, now, you know what? We're kind of running out of time, so I'm going to actually skip ahead. I've kind of created one already. So what I've done here, just kind of sped up the process like a cooking show. I have an already almost complete one where I've recorded already the guitar. In the same way, I've recorded the guitar, just one chord progression, and then it loops over and over again. Here, you can hear that. It just loops over and over again. And oh, and I made a little intro thing too. And another thing that is important is the arrangement of it. So you got the intro here, intro, and then you've got a verse. And then, remember after the verse, we changed chord progressions a little bit, so I had to change away from the main chord progression here to a little bit of a different one. Okay. Now, I need my microphone. It's kind of hiding back here. Get it out of here. Okay, sorry, I was kind of unprepared for that microphone. Now, let's see if we can just do a little final recording on it. Oh, and paste that in there. And now that I have all that stuff recorded, I should be able to get a good vocal recording in here. Whoops, not a guitar. Sorry about that. So I hope this is educational for you guys. If you guys have never seen this before, it might be a little bit overwhelming, but you know, it's a learning curve doing this kind of stuff. But it can be so much fun, and it's honestly so cool to be able to, you know, create your own finished songs out of this stuff. So, try to do again audio. And for me personally, I like to put some. Where's that? Oh, here. I just want to put a couple of filters on it. Pitch correction filter. Just in case my voice sounds terrible, and something called CLA vocals, which helps to, you know, create some reverb and stuff. Turn that off, and yeah, so you know, this is kind of advanced stuff, but just find something that works for your voice, and you'll find different plugins that work. So check, oh no, check, I think it's using the wrong input. So change to input one, and we're gonna record this thing live right here. Check, check. Check, check. Check. All right. Check one, two, here we go. All right. I'm gonna try to record this here. Wish me luck. Signed into my Zoom class. My internet is so bad. My friends are all in boxes and they're frozen. There's a cat on my keyboard. Somebody's knocking on the front door. Spill water on my laptop, now it's frozen. How am I supposed to learn like this? Well, I can't seem to find the focus. Stuck at home, I'm feeling hopeless. Tired of online school. Technology drives me crazy. Lockdown life, I'm feeling lazy. Tired of online school. Online school. So sick of online school. I finally rebooted, but my microphone was muted. My friends are all in breakout. Whiteboard is open, but my keyboard is broken. I miss when I could write our answers with a pen. How am I supposed to learn like this? I can't seem to find focus. Stuck at home, I'm feeling hopeless. Tired of online school. Technology drives me crazy. Stuck at home, I'm feeling lazy. Tired of online school. All right, so if you do make a mistake like that, what you can do is just start. You can just do one section at a time. All right, so I'm just gonna start again right at the bridge.
School, it's not as bad as it could be. I'm just grateful we've got technology. I just wanna see some faces. Being a hole outside the screen. Seem to find the focus. Stuck at home, I'm feeling hopeless. Tired of online school. Technology drives me crazy. Stuck at home, I'm feeling lazy. Tired of online school. Online school. So sick of
All right, that's it. That's it. Now, I think we're about out of time, guys. But I'm going to turn it up a little bit. You might not have heard it very well because it was a little bit quiet, I think. But let's take a quick listen to how it sounds, at least at the beginning. I think it turned out pretty well, guys. Thank you for joining me on this journey, writing this song.
Internet is so bad. My friends are all in boxes and they're frozen.
Now, obviously, this is just the rough vocals. I would probably record another vocal.
On the front door. Spill water on my laptop, now it's frozen. How am I supposed to learn like this?
Here we go.
Well, I can't seem to find the focus. Stuck at home, I'm feeling hopeless. Tired of online school. technology drives me crazy. Lockdown life, I'm feeling lazy.
You can throw some harmonies on top as well if you want.
Online
school.
There's
so many things you can do.
Online school. So sick of online school.
That's just an example of some of the things you can do. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for joining me on this journey. I hope that everybody out there, you know, writes your own songs and use some of the tips that I had to, you know, just write a little bit better song and finish those songs. I hope I get to hear it someday. Thank you very much, everybody. My name's Aaron John. You guys can follow me at Aaron John Jams if you want to check.